Okay, we're going to be doing the Bass Lake hiking trail today. I've been here before and I think I've brought you along on it. When I've done it before, I've always done the shorter loop here, which is I think about 2 miles or so. This time we're going to try doing the longer loop, which is about 2 miles, no, about 6 miles. I believe, round trip. Now the first part of this trail is designated for wheelchairs, so it's pretty easy, but it ceases being easy fairly quickly after that. At this point right here. So again, where I've usually gone before is up around here, and this time we're heading down this way. There's the place to get into the lake there, and then we're gonna go on around here and back here. So long ways to go. It's not the best of days out here. Somewhere in the 40s, you can probably hear the wind whistling through the trees. Could be nicer, could be a lot worse. In fact, actually, not that far to the south of us, they're getting lots and lots and lots of rain. So, but it's my birthday. And I wanted to get out and do something that I wanted to do. And I thought coming out here, taking Ruby for a hike, but it's just the right thing. So here we are. Now I actually have Ruby tethered to me with a 10-foot leash. This is supposed to be 10 feet. It seems longer than that, but so when I want to take photos or whatever, I can do it hands-free. I am pretty sure she would stay with me. My biggest concern is how she behaves when she meets other people and other dogs. She's friendly, but she's overly so. She thinks all dogs want to play with her. She thinks all people want to play with her too. So she tends to jump up at them, mouth them. In general, goes pretty crazy, so. There were a couple of other cars in the parking lot, so obviously there are other people around in here. Whether we'll actually run into them or not, I really don't know. But don't want to take any chances. So, I figured by tethering her, when I do want to take photos, I've got both hands free, so that won't be an issue. Now, other dogs I've had, Sam especially, would have gone nuts with the leash dragging underneath your body like that. She doesn't seem to mind. On our walks, I tend to spent a lot of time extricating the leash from underneath her, but doesn't take very long and it's underneath again. So hopefully you as a viewer don't get too upset by it either. Once in a while she'll get herself untangled, like she's almost ready to do now. Whoops, no. Suppose I really should have her on a harness that has the clip on the top. Keep that from happening, but like I said, she doesn't. It doesn't bother her at all. There's the marsh at the head of the lake there. Thank you. Wow. Wow. Come this way. Okay, I'm down here. Ruby, down here. Good. All right. Wow. So there's Bass Lake, everybody. Right directly across here where I'm looking right now. That's where that Dry Falls is. And we'll be there eventually, assuming we make the whole trail. Oh man. What a beautiful vista. Wow. I bet this cliff that we're standing on is quite something to see from a canoe down there. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. Okay. Look at this root ball. Wow. So a few splashes of color around. Okay, we're beyond the end of the lake now, and the Bass Lake. So we'll be approaching the halfway point. Should be approaching the halfway point before too long. That lake over there that you can see, that is Low Lake. Okay. toilet up that way, apparently. I don't need it. Come on, this way. Come on. Stop it. Well, there's a campsite here on a little lake. We actually, back when I did Ruby's first canoe ride, we actually came to this campsite. I have footage of that, but I ended up editing that out of the final cut, because it really didn't add to the story of her first canoe trip very well. So anyway, unfortunately, as we were coming into this campsite, my battery died, so I wasn't able to get that approach shot that I really wanted to get. There's actually at least two sites here. I'll turn you around in a minute and show you. There's fire rings at both sites, but there's no sitting logs or anything, so I don't know if there's another one further down here or not, but I knew there were two just from our other visit out here. So anyway, I knew that this trail looped around by these campsites, so they're accessible both from the trail and from the water. So it can be used either canoeing or hiking. So anyway, this has got to be about the halfway point. It's about 3 o'clock now. We started out about noon. It's going to be 6 o'clock before we finish this hike at this rate, which is getting kind of late this time of year. So I did bring a flashlight along with me, or a headlight, so we should be okay. But here on in, I may not be able to take quite so much video because, we're running out of time. We're going to run out of daylight. So I'll take what I can and see how it goes. Ruby's really getting antsy to move on, but I needed to take a break. I've got to get something to snack on and some water. And then I'll be on the trail again. Some water. Some water. Out of the hand, not the bottle. Out of my hand. Okay, We're at this point here. So there's a portage that goes across right around in here somewhere. Looks like a pretty steep portage. And we still have to go all the way around here. So not quite halfway, actually. I'm not really... Is that the portage up there? Ooh, I hope not. Huh. Okay, Ruby, let's go. Okay, so we are at 4. So we made it to there. So we've been up and around and up, and we're at this point here. So 0.3, 1.1, 1.3, 1.3, whole miles back to the parking lot. So now we are back on trail that I'm familiar with, although I've always done it the other way around. So we're going backwards now. No, we're not going that way. Not going that way. Going this way. She wanted to go to the campsite. So there's Dry Lake. Okay. Okay, we're at 3 here, so there's a couple campsites back in there, so that's what's that way, but we're going that way, so here we go. And now we're coming up on Dry Falls. Last time we were here, she was able to get water here very carefully. She also got wet because she kind of slid in. So all you need come on, you're gonna fall in again. Come on, up this way. Just a minute, I can't do that. Yeah. Yeah. You're a lot more agile than I am. Thank you. Sit on this bench. Oh. Take a breather. I know we've got ways to go to get down here, but I need a breather. Let's go then. Up the steps. Up, 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 up. Up we go. Up we go. Keep going. We go this way. Yep. That's the way. Let's go. Come on. Keep going. Down there you should be able to see, that's the Bass Lake landing down there that we saw earlier on in our hike today. Come on Ruby, this way. Thank you. Come on. Oops. come here. Ruby, come here. It's a little bit wider up here, so. Ruby, come. That's okay. Stop recording. We are now, we're at number two, way down here. Can you see that? I got 0.2 miles back to that intersection and then just a short walk back to the parking lot. So, we are almost there. Almost there, Ruby. Almost there. Come on, keep going. Let's go. Let's go. And here we are back at point one, right there, just a short distance up to the parking lot. So thanks for coming along with me, with us, on my birthday hike. Hope to see you on trail someday. Nibby Rocks out.